is fully engaged and fully committed to the tricky and often unpleasant process of shaking up Washington. If he can get these entrenched elites in D.C. to secure this border and focus on the needs of the American people in the immigration debate, that alone will be a massive victory for this president and for the country. As the details of this DACA plan unfold, we're going to be watching and very closely. And that's the angle. For reaction, let's bring in our guests. Columnist for the Washington Examiner and Fox News contributor Byron York here in Washington, also here in Washington. Washington Times opinion editor and Fox News contributor Charlie Hurt. And in Miami, five-time Emmy Award-winning journalist Elvira Salazar, currently the anchor of Mega TV's nightly newscast. Great to see all of you. Elvira, let's start with you on this. The president pleased Jeb Bush today with his approach to immigration. He looked to me very in command of the room. He was looking like he wanted to come up with some solution. I may not love the solution in the end, but boy, he seems to want to get to results and bring all parties to the table.
And we are very happy about that, and good evening, and thanks for inviting me. I wrote at the beginning of this year and for Newsmax that Trump was going to be for immigration what Nixon was for China. Only somebody that is such an anti-staunch, anti-legal immigration could pave the way, as we saw today, to acquire and to be able to achieve something that has not been able to be done in the last 30 years, which is to not only to give some type of legality to the DACA kids, but to take care of the 11 million people. And that we can go into that discussion. How are we going to do that? But President Trump showed today that he is willing to put political capital that he has, and now political willingness to solve the problem, starting with the DACA kids.
Charlie Hurt, when I hear the president say we're going to do a DACA deal, to me that removes the leverage, because if someone knows that you're going to do the deal, well, where's your leverage there? I'm a little concerned about that. I mean, the focus should be on the American people first. What's good for them?
I'm totally concerned as well. But if at the end of the day, what he's trying to do is he's luring Democrats into negotiating all this, and then at the end of the day, they refuse to go along with it because it has security measures in it, then he can beat them up about it. But what I think was most interesting about this thing today, for an hour, Donald Trump opened up that meeting so that the American people could see what politicians, when they get behind closed doors, talking about this stuff. All they talked about was DACA. They must have said DACA 1,000 times.
Yeah, where was all the other stuff? Immigration judges?
And all the other people. Yeah. All the other people that are affected by the illegal immigration. None of that ever got brought up. All everybody could agree upon was DACA. And if Republicans go along with this and do some sort of DACA deal that doesn't include serious enforcement, including chain migration, no.
DHS Secretary Byron said, well, enforcement has to be part of the deal. Yeah. I heard that really, I was on the plane, a 5-hour delay coming back from Atlanta. That was fun. So I was sitting there like trying to pull stuff up on YouTube, and I heard that like, wait, part of the deal? Enforcement is a solemn obligation of this government, and it can't be in the future. It's got to be real and meaningful, and Trump said the wall.
Yeah, I did not see any agreement taking place at this meeting. And there was the section that worried a lot of immigration hardliners was this exchange between Senator Feinstein and the president. And Senator Feinstein did the classic Democratic strategy, which is, why don't you give us everything we want first? And then we'll talk about what you want. And it sounded as if the president agreed with that. And then I watched it and then I read the transcript.
Well, let's play it, guys. Let's play it. We actually have the exchange. Okay. So let's let our viewers watch. Then you can comment, Elvira.
All right.
I'll just read it because it's quicker. So the president said, I have no problem. I think that's basically what Dick is saying. Well, Dick Durbin was saying, let's do a clean DACA, right?
I read the transcript. I missed that part of the campaign. The president says DACA, he means DACA, wall, chain migration, and visa lottery.
Yeah, and I'm going to hit
that's
lotto.
What he
Maybe
says.
Yeah, tomorrow.
You know, you see, what you guys, I think what you guys are missing What we're missing here is that we got to put this to rest. We got to finish with this DACA immigration deal so we can move on and do other things. You know, we in the Hispanic community, and I do represent millions of us and people that think like me, is that we don't like to keep on talking about this immigration. We want to put an end to it. We want some type of immigration reform law that will include not necessarily citizenship, but some type of legality, not only for the DACA kids.
I have a question for you, Elvira. Do you think that the DACA people who are upwards of 37, 38 years old now, should they then be allowed to bring in their aunts, uncles, cousins twice removed, like the chain migration, that spider web of people who come in? Should that
all be part of this? And I know where you're going. I believe that, first of all, we're talking about from 16-year-old to 30-year-old, 800,000 kids, I mean, young adults, that are, most of them are working. Okay, they're kids, you know, they're working. But the main problem here is that they did not know that they were breaking the law. And, you know, we are Americans, and we are the beacon of human rights. So if you do not know, because you are too little to understand, not only that, you're fully assimilated. You speak English. You forgot how to speak Spanish. You're working. You're not a gang member.
Merits. We got 2,300 criminals as members of that have been caught.
And then, you know, they should be out of here.
So
we don't want criminals.
The question on chain migration, which is what
the kids,
to me, that's an explosion. Yeah, so should
parents
of the DACA, should they be able to stay?
Right,
they're also illegal. So that's 1.8 million people who will be allowed to stay here legally. That's a big number. Let Charlie get on this. Big number jump from 800,000.
Let me answer you.
That I think came out of this meeting today was Donald Trump said, look, I'm going to campaign on this. I'm going to make it a political issue. Democrats can't defend chain migration. Yeah. But one other thing about the DACA is go ahead.
He has to campaign on this. Remember, there are 49 Democrats in the Senate. They're all opposed to this. There are four Republican senators who have signed on to this clean DACA Dream Act.
Flake.
That's McCain, 53. It is Cory Gardner, Flake.
Oh, my God, Cory Gardner. Well, he's not pushing
Lindsey
pot
Graham
legalization,
and Lisa Murkowski.
The illegal aliens. Yeah. Elvira, really quickly, should chain migration
this
be part?
This is a thorny. This is the scenario. It's like, for me to be able to save my child, I need to leave him. And, you know, that's not a very pleasant position
to be in.
And I understand what you're saying.
When criminals in the United States, when they commit a crime, guess what? They're separated from their children. That's called repercussions for violating our law. So this idea that everybody's a saint that comes in as a legal immigrant. Everyone's a valedictorian and saving cats from trees. And regular workers have to suck it up, Buttercup. I just think it's ridiculous.
And
what about the culpability
of the parents? Let me just say this.
The parents don't have any culpability.
For the parents. The parents do. The parents broke the law, but you know system allowed them to stay here for more than 10 years.
It's all a scam.
The system,
elected Donald Trump
Democrats,
to end the scam. I appreciate Elvira, Byron. We could have you guys on for an hour. This is why I want longer segments. Thank you, guys. By the way.